Cece, can you not do your usual thing? These are really good guys. Best behavior.
Sure.
I'm gonna use the ladies.
What's up, Cecilia?
Cece's really vulnerable right now, and when she's drunk, she has no boundaries. So she's really grabby, really physical. She's really loose with her body. So I just want to apologize in advance for anything that she might do.
It's good to know.
Hurry up. Sorry, I can't find any bigger towels for some reason.
You have a really beautiful body, Cece. I really appreciate that about
you. Okay, come on. I need your
breakfast. Schmidt, yeah. Go up to the roof.
Yeah, I'm gonna go up to the roof.
I'll be there in 10 minutes.
Cool, see you in like 10.
Sorry that Cece did this to you.
It's okay. I'm used to it. I guess I'll just always be the fat kid with the big dreams.
It's not you. I love Cece, but she's not ready for you.
Hey, Cece, look.
I get it. This isn't gonna happen. The couch is super uncomfortable. My sunburn's starting to blister. And I just want to sleep in my own bed.
Okay. I'm sorry for everything. I can be a jerk sometimes.
If you tell anyone we held hands, I have two people on my phone that will kill you. Literally. Schmidt yelled at me earlier.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Did he get weird? He's weird about cooking. Did you touch his whisk?
No, the thing is, Jess, is I think I'm into him.
What? Oh, my God.
Yeah, he's got this rage inside of him, this fury, and I just love it.
So you said you wanted to see me for something?
Yes. I brought you a gift.
Good friend Schmidt, and he just came by to bring me a gift, so.
That smell.
That's your perfume.
You wore it?
Yeah, and it smells terrible.
That
I'm gonna make her jealous.
All right, can you stop? Cece, you are way too beautiful. She'll think she doesn't have a shot with me. Can you stop looking at me like that, please?
What look? I'm not even looking at you.
The pouty one. What is happening out there?
Stop. Look, what is it? Somebody can't just slap me and I say that you drunk me and it's my word against yours, okay?
Okay.
Wish there was a word that meant complete satisfaction and complete self-loathing.
I've never seen a woman bite her own shoulder before.
That was the last time.
I know I said that last time was the last time, but... You want to come down?
Yeah, I want to come. Yeah, I'll come down. That sounds good.
And I want you to know, that was the last time, okay? This is over.
I just end up popping this party for like 20 minutes. When I come back, we'll have sex.
Okay, yeah, let's do it.
Oh, no, I'm going in there alone.
Oh, well, what am I supposed to do?
I'll crack a window for you.
Oh, my. Are you ashamed of me?
Yes, absolutely. 100%. I'm 100% ashamed of you.
Oh, wow, what a revelation.
Okay, come on, Schmidt. I can't be the first woman who's ashamed to be with you.
Okay, look, I won't go into your party if you go to breakfast with me tomorrow. In public.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, really?
Really? I mean, I can survive breakfast.
Do you? Are we even still in L.A.?
Schmidt, you and I are not together. We're not in a relationship. Just having sex.
And I love it.
And I'm not gonna be a prize that you get to show off.
I wanna tell people because I think that you are the dopest, flyest, smartest, ballsiest, bitchiest, truly terrifying woman that I have sexually enjoyed in a really long time. Okay, look, I'm fine with you not telling anybody about us, but you cannot just call me at any time and just summon me for intercourse. I have no control here, and I'm stressed out all day long.
Okay, Schmidt,
You really need to learn to take a breath and calm down, all right? We're just being a little spontaneous.
Okay, wait.
What?
Cece, before we continue, I clearly have no control in this relationship, and I'm fine with it.
Good.
But know this, you're the one who broke into this apartment at 3 a.m. for a little bit of this, Schmidt, so who's really in control?
Shut up!
You obviously like him. It's the only explanation for thinking that's funny.
Oh my God, I think you're right.
And you didn't want to tell me because you knew that I would know. And you weren't ready to admit it to yourself.
Okay.
What are you doing with that basil, Cece? You trying to make me confess? Easy with the knife, Robespierre.
I will cut off your weaker finger, Schmidt, and I'm going to start with your pinky.
You guys are adorable.
We are not adorable, okay? We are just two people having casual, successful sex.
My bad.
Just thinking that we're a cute couple is... it's kind of a turnoff. How do we explain to her that this is just, it's just sex?
Okay, the pregnancy test doesn't work until after 6 days. So just get through the weekend and don't tell Schmidt until you're sure.
Yeah, no, of course not, of course.
I think it's time that I take you on a real date.
You're asking me out on a date?
Yeah, it'll be our first real date.
I can't go right now. It's a really bad time, okay? I'm sorry, just take someone else.
You mean like another girl?
Yeah.
When you do, just make sure you always use protection because even if he says it's tantric and you're Indian and you know better, you're just gonna end up pregnant anyways.
What? Cece, are you pregnant?
Okay, I don't know. We have to wait for the test results, but I'm late.
You're okay about this? Because I'm freaking out by the fact that you're not freaking out.
Yeah, I'm oddly calm about the whole thing. Look, Nick, maybe this isn't exactly my 5-year plan, but maybe this is fate. You know, maybe I hit the jackpot. Maybe this is the universe telling me that I'm never going to find a girl better than Cece. Cece, are you crying?
No, I don't know.
You are an amazing woman, and you're going to do and be so many things in this life. Maybe you'll be a mom, and maybe not. But I will support you no matter what.
There is a God! I got my period! It's so amazing!
Oh my God. Oh.
I got my period.
She got her period.
Just go back to the way things were. You can go on your date.
Right, Nicole.
No more stupid mistakes, right?
We've barely spoken since I almost impregnated you.
You know, it's this whole thing has just kind of got me thinking. Maybe this is just too intense and we should stop.
That's what you want?
That's how I feel right now. Oh. Hey, Schmidt.
What up?
So Nadia's excited for your date tonight.
I bet.
Why don't you just tell him you like him?
It doesn't matter if I like him. It's over. And you're fine with that.
Yeah. Being I cannot believe I can't.
How are you upset right now? Cece, you ended this. I don't know what you want from me.
I don't want you sleeping with Nadia. Are you crazy? I don't want you sleeping with anyone. Because I like you.
How does a guy like me have a chance at making someone like Cece happy?
You don't. Not with all those moles on your face.
I should just give up.
That's crazy. She needs you. You are exactly what she needs.
You know, for the first time in my life, I actually feel like I want something that lasts. And I want it with you.
I feel the same way.
Trying to believe that.
My shoot earlier and was so jealous. He was freaking out the entire time.
Hey, it's for you.
What about the shoot? You kind of left before I had a chance to say goodbye.
Good stuff, sure. It was hard to tell where you stopped and goggles and a card body began.
That's my job. Gino is just some guy that I see around the office, except for in my office, they rub us down with baby oil before we start.
Yeah, I get that. I got, look, your business is selling sex. Sure. You're a sex worker.
How many have you had?
Like three.
It's a lot of pig farts.
It's just Cece.
I thought it was going so well between you guys.
Yeah. Well, she's a good egg. She's never going to be happy with somebody like me, Jess.
What? That's crazy. You want Cece to go away?
No. I want her to be happy. Because when you care about somebody, you do what's best for them. Even if it sucks for you. We need to talk.
All right. This is not another one of those Merlot is the whore of the vineyard talks, is it?
This isn't working out.
Are you kidding right now? Are you trying to end this with me? Why are you trying to push me away?
I saw your phone, Cece. I saw the text message from Gino, your colleague.
You went through my phone?
What? No. Winston went through your phone.
That is not okay. This is about trust, Schmidt, okay? It's about trust, and I told you how this was gonna be, and I asked you to get okay with it.
How am I supposed to trust you, Cece? You slept with me. I mean, that doesn't say much about your taste in men.
Check out the new and improved Schmidt. I'm hearing so much about it, so.
I'm really glad that you came. Look, I wanted to tell you.
I want you to meet Robbie, my boyfriend.
Why didn't you call me back in 2 months, Cece?
You were the one who broke up with me.
I don't see you until you show up here tonight with the boyfriend.
Come on, okay? You and I both know we never would have worked. We are far too alike.
Both so beautiful.
You're gonna be fine. You know that, right?
Hey, Cece, I gotta know. Why him? I mean, what is his brand?
He's just a good guy.
And too dangerous?
Yeah, that's it. I'll see you around, Schmidt. Where have you been?
Oh, God, I'm sorry. I totally lost track of time. We decided that we're going to hang out more. Well, all of us are going to hang out. You know, because I remember you saying that you missed hanging out with Schmidt.
Oh, Robbie.
And you said that?
Yeah, I said it, but...
No, because I want to hang out with you, too.
With Robbie there?
Yeah, with Robbie there.
Good.
Good.
Oh, yeah, good.
You're such a nice guy.
Thank you.
What you deserve is a girl who respects you, you know? A nice girl.
I'm not into the nice thing, Robbie. Doesn't do it for me.
Well, that's what I thought, too.
Yeah.
You know, until I found this one right here.
You mean Cece?
You think that I'm nice?
No. I think you're the nicest.
Robbie.
Schmidt, am I nice?
No.
Thank you. I'm in California. Nobody thinks I'm a nice girl, okay? I'm the mistake.
Ah, Robbie. Midwestern heart, Midwestern body.
I'm the one who messes things up.
I agree with you.
I feel like he doesn't even know me. What happens when he realizes he was wrong about me the entire time? He's just gonna run away.
I would never run away. But if I did, I would run way faster than that. Because he's slow.
Maybe I'm just not meant for a functional relationship. You know me, Schmidt.
You don't ever have to be nice around me. I'm not scared of you.
I mean, I'm bad. I do bad things.
I don't think you're a nice girl. I think you're the worst.
No.
No.
No, I can't do this to Robbie.
That is doing nothing right now from stopping me from wanting to kiss you.
Stop.
I don't want to stop. I really don't. I will never stop wanting to kiss you. I am a monster.
Hey, Cece, you okay?
Yeah, I'm good. Just broke up with Robbie.
Don't make me a drink.
Wow, there's cool. It's cool. But you're single. You're single. She's single now. Technically, you're single. Are you not
Schmidt,
single?
Schmidt, I have to get serious about my future. Otherwise, my mom is going to set me up with 100 sweet, gentle, painfully boring Indian guys.
I'm in love, man. I'm in love with Cece.
Yeah, everyone knows that, you dumbass. You always have been.
I got to tell her, man.
Well, you should do that, Schmidt. That sounds great.
What are you doing?
I love you, Cece. And I have been in love with you for so long.
Is this real for you?
Yes. Cece, I'm ready for a serious commitment. I'm up for a huge promotion at work. I'm ready to have kids with you if that's what you want.
You want to have kids?
Let's go right now. Let's go make a kid.
Schmidt, we have so much going against us.
Let's have dinner.
Tonight.
Okay.
Have you tried Double V?
No.
Let's open up this bitch.
Let's open up. Okay.
We're gonna do every vitamin in alphabetical order. Each shot that you do makes me know you're going that extra mile.
Is
there something more important than work?
Okay. No. Let's just. All right. We'll do it.
I did it. I'm here for dinner. I made it.
It's really late.
We got the account. I was with my boss. We got the account. We did it.
Who with your boss?
What?
The woman who made you sign a contract so she could have sex with you?
No. No. Yeah. No, but nothing happened. She just wanted me to taste the V.
Pay for our baby's college now. Literally anywhere they want to go. UCLA, UMass, any of the U schools.
You should
probably. I'm not. It's okay. Hey, Mom, it's me. I think I'm ready to have you set me up.
Hey.
You okay?
What's wrong?
I told Cece that I loved her. And then I got drunk. She called her mom, and she's calling Brown. She wants to marry Brown, man.
Hey, I know you're trying to avoid me, but just take this gift I got you and I will walk away.
I don't celebrate Christmas, okay? Or as I like to call it, white Anglo-Saxon winter privilege night.
I really want us to be friends whenever you're ready. Because I really do care about you.
Thank you so much for this. Because this makes it so much better. And you could tell me if I'm off, but I see it on your face when you say that he's the one that you want. And you're spending all your time in this wrong situation. And anytime you want to stop.
It was a bracelet.
I don't even know what you're talking about.
Tungsten carbide. Because you said that was the most baller metal.
That's what staked them in all the transporter movies.
I just wanted to try to find a way to say thank you for telling me that you loved me. Even if I was the wrong person.
You're welcome.
Another Indian guy?
My mom set me up.
Oh, your mom. Mm-hmm. That's cool. Have fun with your devs and your ninjas or your Deepaks.
Get over here now.
Wait, what?
You told me you had moved on.
Only people who haven't moved on say things like that. I'm a squirrel. You're my nut. Winter's coming. I'm gonna store you my cheek, girl.
Please leave.
You and I not being together does not make sense to me. I miss your body and the things I used to do to it.
Schmidt.
I'm talking about sex.
Today is about me finding someone within my own culture that I can build my life with. It's about more than sex.
Plan has changed. I'm still marrying an Indian guy.
No, yeah, that's okay? Fine. He went home with a Jew and a turban, so I'm just saying.
Just take this off. Come on, let's go. I missed this.
Turban on, turban off.
I'm gonna hate myself for saying this, but turban on.
Second you say you'd like me to. I just wanna give you the love that you're missing.
Yes.
Maybe just to wake up with you would be everything I need, and this could be so different. Tell me what you want me to do. Baby, I can treat you better than he can. And anyone like you deserves a
was just so pretty, I didn't want to correct you. But look, the most important thing is that I'm going to do my best to make you the happiest woman on the face of the earth.
Hey, listen, I think it might be good for him if you just gave him some space.
Space?
Cece, you're getting married. It's killing him.
Look, Cece, I just wanted to say that if I was ever selfish in our relationship...
What do you mean if, and what do you mean relationship?
If I was, I sincerely apologize. I'm really happy for you.
Thank you.
Tell me why are we wasting time on all your wasted crime when you should be with me instead? Cause baby, I can treat you better.
I'm sorry, everyone, but I can't do this. This isn't what I want. They want us to be with someone else. Weird day, huh?
It's a beautiful wedding, Cece.
Thank you.
It was Schmidt that you were talking about.
Right. It was.
Two women are in love with me. The problem is I'm in love with both of them.
Okay, it looks like you're gonna have to choose.
Cece and I, we have this connection. God.
Okay, fine. Schmidt, choose Cece.
Yeah, but I was dating Elizabeth first, so. Wait a minute, Winston. I was dating Elizabeth first.
Look, Schmidt, you wanna know what I think?
No, I don't. Done. Decided. Ha! Cece, out. I was dating Elizabeth first.
It's a very difficult decision that I've had to, you know, you guys have put me in here, but I'm gonna be candid.
I have been up for 24 hours. I have to return all of these gifts. So just say it. You don't wanna be with me.
Of course I wanna be with you.
Mm.
feel so terrible for Elizabeth.
What are you trying to say, Schmidt? Is it over?
No, no. As if. Of course I picked you. It wasn't even close. Come here, you crazy white girl. There it is. Winston, please, come on. Talk to me. I need a friend right now. I love both of these women, and I can't lose them, and I can't hurt them.
By the way, my office is throwing a party tomorrow, and I'd really like for you to be there.
Well, I have a photo shoot, but I think I could come after that.
Oh, so. Yeah, well, that sounds good.
Who's that?
Mm-hmm. It's my doctor.
Is that Elizabeth?
Okay, look, Cece, I gotta tell you something.
Does Elizabeth work here?
Yes.
Hey, we were just talking about you.
The food was good.
Yeah. I was thinking of taking some home.
You deserve it. Okay, well, I'm heading off. The Asian markets wait for no one. I feel it in the air, a song fixing
my hair, preparing for another day. She was ice cold to you.
Okay, I can do this. Do you know how I broke up with Elizabeth so that I could start dating Cece again?
Absolutely, it was really hard for her.
Yeah, that actually never happened.
What do you mean?
I'm still dating Elizabeth.
What do you mean?
I'm dating both of them and neither one of them knows that, and I feel terrible about it.
But Elizabeth is gone. What do you mean?
She's not gone.
So you broke up with Cece?
I didn't break up with either one of them.
You are a lowlife.
I get it.
How could you do this to her?
Jess, I am so sorry.
Cece's gonna walk through that door any minute, and you have to tell her the truth.
Jess, please, this would wreck her. I'm begging you. I know you don't believe me, but I do care about her.
Either you tell her, or I will, Schmidt.
You're right. I'll tell her. I've been cheating on you with Elizabeth. Cece, I'm sorry. Is there some place maybe we could go talk?
Everybody knows anyway, Schmidt. Might as well just say it.
No, let's talk. This should be fine. I didn't want to hurt you. You have to know that I did not want to hurt you, please. I'm begging you, if you take anything away from this, know that I did not want to hurt you. I didn't want to hurt anyone, especially you. You have no idea what you mean to me. And I got caught up in this thing, and I got lost. And I'm sorry.
You're sorry. You don't want to hurt anybody? That's the best you can do, Schmidt? Really? I don't know. I don't know you. Goodbye, Schmidt.
I brought you guys in here to talk about Schmidt. I'm really worried about him. He hasn't been to work for 3 days. He just sits on the couch eating cold cuts and yelling at the news about how nothing matters.
He's just going through a whole thing. You know, the Cece Elizabeth breakup has gotten to him.
Right now he is completely unhinged.
Guys, I can't believe I'm saying this, but I miss the old Schmidt. I want him to be happy again. He's crumbling before our very eyes. I came to find out if you're coming to my party today. You never answered my email.
Yeah, I meant to tell you I can't make it. Sorry.
I've been going out drinking a lot lately. It's kind of wiping me out.
Please come to my party, Cece.
Schmidt, you know, I don't think I'm ready for that.
Yeah. So. What if I could promise you Schmidt wouldn't be there? Sorry.
No, Jess, it's fine. It's fine. In fact, it's actually kind of perfect. I think since this whole thing went down, I've just been running away. You know, I mean, actually seeing Schmidt, I finally feel like I have some closure.
Well, good. I'm glad. You deserve some.
Coach gave me an out. He said, just say the word and it's off. And you know what? I'm just gonna say the word.
No! No!
You call it, you say.
No, Schmidt! God, you can't do that to Cece. She's just starting to move on. All we have to do is get through the night.
Just get through the night.
You just have to get your mind off her.
I can't mingle with this trash. I've been to the mountaintop.
Okay, look. Look at me. You are moving on. Now, where's the old Schmidt? When I moved into the loft, you used to pull so many ladies. You were legendary.
Look, you're a beautiful woman. In another life, we certainly would have been lovers, but my soulmate is at a Sparks game right now with another man. I need to go get her.
I love her, Jess. I have to tell her.
Well, you can't. You have to let her go.
Look, you're right, I know.
What are you doing here, Schmidt?
Nick thought you might need some help.
Yeah, well, I don't, okay? So, you can go.
Maybe I'll just stay for a little bit. Double tap some insta-G's.
A customer ordered an old-fashioned, and she got gin in a mug with a peanut in it.
I'll fix it.
Make me an old-fashioned right now, or I'm gonna call the manager, and I wanna talk to him anyway because he's just gorgeous.
The old-fashioned. One of my favorite drinks, a classic cocktail. Just a half ounce of simple syrup. Splash, water, two dashes of bitters. Mix that up with some ice. And then
look at that. Old fashioned.
Old fashioned?
Oh, my stars and garters, you made a drink.
He's right, though. I can't do anything, no skills. I told you this, but I didn't even graduate high school.
A lot of people never graduated high school.
Why did I think that I could bartend?
Because you can. You are strong, and you are confident. Those are skills. Use them. Be a little bit meaner to the people here. It should be easier for you. Just pretend that they're me.
You're right, that is easy.
And pull your shirt down a little bit. This isn't a monastery.
Do not push your luck with me.
I'll look away. What?
So I cleaned out the bear trap, I polished all these wine glasses, and I turned that penis graffiti in the bathroom into a whimsical hat. Now my friend and I have to go to a party. All right, Schmidt, let's go.
You called me your friend?
Did I?
Help! Bouncer's after me.
Oh!
Okay.
He's gone. He's gone, Schmidt.
Is he gone?
Mm-hmm. You can stop now.
He's tenacious. He's definitely gonna be back.
Pretty sure it's all clear.
It's always good to see old friends. Thank you.
Schmidt, I know that Abby is fun and she is charming, but I'm telling you, she's bad news.
Is that why you guys are sorting through my garbage? I appreciate the concern, you guys, but Abby has changed. No, I knew she
girl for a couple weeks, okay? I've known her for 20 years, and I am telling you, she's not to be trusted.
What are you guys doing here? Tailing me?
No.
Yes, we're tailing you. I know how you work. You glom onto guys, and then you just bleed them dry. Well, you are not going to do it to Schmidt.
Cece, darling.
What?
How long have we been friends?
Week or so?
And have I ever steered you wrong?
No.
So I'm going to need you to figure out why you're really doing all this for Schmidt.
Anyway, I just want to apologize. It was wrong of me to get involved.
Are you sure you don't want to tap Abby's phone, run a DNA sample? I don't want to be coarse, but the bedroom was Carter.
I was worried about you. Okay, I didn't want her to take advantage of you, because I know that you would do anything for the people that you care about.
Well, I guess I could say the same thing about you.
What's that?
It's a class ring for Cece. She got her GED and I've been tutoring her, so I had this made.
You're still in love with her.
I am not still in love with her.
You're alone on a boat with Cece, romantic cruise, and you give her jewelry. Then what?
I tell her that I'm still in love with her and that I want her back, and then we have sex until the boat sinks.
I knew it!
Well, you only need the light when it's burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love her when you let her go.
I just wanted
to say... Grubbing us?
No!
Sweet mother of sea dragon!
What? What happened?
Cece.
Hey.
Your hair in the moonlight. Looks so shiny.
You know, I'm trying to get a signal so I can talk to Buster, but it's just impossible out here.
Why is it so important for you to get in touch with Buster?
Look, you know better than anyone that I don't have the best of luck with relationships. And I know you think he's young for me.
I don't. I just want you to be happy.
Thank you.
God, what is she doing here? I thought she was in Australia. How do I look? How Jewish, I mean. Good Jewish or bad Jewish?
Oh, Nancy, that feels like a trap. Come on, come with me.
I haven't told the guys that you broke up with Buster yet, because I feel like I might have to tell Schmidt outside a hospital.
You're not doing this tonight.
What?
You're not doing this.
No, listen, Joe.
You're not doing this tonight. Cece. Stop doing this. Cece has a boyfriend, and your obsession with her is not good for you, man. She's been away all summer, and you have been killing it. Get your little white butt back out there and finish the summer of sex that you started.
That's what I'm talking about. Cece gone.
See that bridesmaid right there? The pretty one?
Sure do.
The foxy lady?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you're going home with her tonight, and I got your back.
Look at that. She looks like the girl from the commercial playing tennis with a tampon in. Let's do it. So you and Buster broke up. Sorry.
Hey, I'm just waiting for you to do something weird now.
Yeah, I feel like I'm done, so I'm gonna go.
Sorry. Is Cece checking out Schmidt?
What?
What are you talking about, Winston?
Shame, shame, I know your name.
You do not know my name. Doing?
Okay, look, I know I can't stop this, and I accept that, but I just wanted to stop it long enough so that I could say goodbye.
Oh, look, this is a low-risk procedure, okay? I'm gonna be fine. Oh, you meant say goodbye to my boobs. I forgot who I was talking to. No, Schmidt, you cannot see my boobs.
I need to look them in the eyes. I can't let them leave without knowing how much they've meant to me.
I'll let them know.
No, I need to tell them myself. I mean, I guess if I'm being honest, it doesn't matter what size you are. I'm always gonna love you because you're attached to the most beautiful person in the whole world. Well, Lucy left. Turns out she's a bit of an anti-Semite.
Hmm.
Yeah, looks like we both struck out.
Okay, Schmidt, there is no Jeff. Come on. But to be honest, I'm kind of glad there isn't. You know, Thanksgiving should be spent with the people that you care about. Look, I know this is kind of dumb to say, but I really like being your friend. Only hate the road when you're missing home.
Only know you love her.
My friend. I like being your friend too.
Yeah. Merry Christmas, Schmidt.
Merry Christmas, Celia.
Oh, God.
Here, Cece, have some water.
No, thank you. No.
Valentine's Day just sucks.
I don't know. I kind of like it.
Since when?
Since a few years ago. Since 3 years ago, to be exact.
Oh, what happened
It was when you first took a chance on me. And we humped until the sun came out. Did all the things that R. Kelly raps about.
Yeah, I know. I was there.
It was the best night of my life, and ever since then, Valentine's Day has always been my favorite holiday, and I hope that you don't remember that I've said any of these things tomorrow.
I did the whole crawl to find you. I'm cold, I'm tired, I'm sober. I'm wearing my strapless bra like a belt, but I know what I want. I want you. I want you to be my boyfriend.
Jake Apex is coming to the wedding.
Jake Apex?
Who is Jake Apex?
Jake Apex is Cece's high school crush. Never did anything for me, but turned Cece to soup. Thanks.
Dead. Apparently Jake Apex has to work, so he's not gonna come to the wedding. I'm wearing the craziest underwear for nothing.
Okay, look, Cece, you know what we do? We regroup.
No, it's fine, Schmidt. I'm over it.
It is not fine. Look, Cece, you're the most amazing woman I ever met. If you want Jake Apex, I'm gonna help you get Jake Apex. Never gonna stop trying to make you happy, Cece.
Hey, Kelly.
Hey, so, I'd love to see you again before you leave. To be honest with you, Cece, I've always had a crush on you.
Oh, God. Okay, so I've never said this out loud before, but I'm in love with someone else.
She hasn't answered any of my texts, and I'm starting to get worried.
Jess is starting to find your behavior suspicious. That's a police word.
It's not a police word, Winston. It's a very common word. And you know why I'm keeping my distance. I like Schmidt.
For the second time!
I know how many times!
So it is Schmidt.
Yeah. I know that you would do anything for anybody, but right now I just need you to be there for me and hold my hand, okay? That's all.
Teaching me how to be the most effective and successful man and lover I possibly can be.
Really? I thought you were fine before.
When you two were together. Which time? The first time or the third time? Because you two were very off and on in a very confusing way.
I've had sex with him so many times.
We have a fun thing together, don't
Super
we?
Super fun. Yeah, I really enjoy it.
What is her? What is it, Cecil? What is your name?
You'll learn it. Don't worry.
Yes. I mean, what do you think, Cece? You like Fawn, right?
Yeah, I mean, as long as you're happy.
Glitter in it, no.
You look like a wood carving of yourself.
The press is here, and single women have proven to be less appealing to voters. Fix it and get here now. I am Fawn Moscato, and I will not miss a photo opportunity.
Fawn? How about a fake beard? Get some double-sided tape, we can shave Winston's cap.
Okay, you know what? Enough. I cannot just stand here and watch Fawn treat you like she's your pageant mom. She needs to accept you exactly how you are, or you need to find somebody that will. Because I think you are fine as is. What was it you wanted to say to me?
Fawn, I don't want to break up with you. I like you just the way that you are.
No offense, but you're terrifying to look at and you smell like a chemical fire.
Ain't that the truth?
Really inspiring. I actually want to be the woman in this book.
Finding inner strength in a time of crises. Cece, are you in crises?
I'm fine. Cece's fine. How are you? What's Fawn holding up? You guys are good then? You know, because the last time we spoke, you said you were feeling a little, you know, used.
Well, not anymore. We're a team now.
I've decided I'm going to climb Mount Shasta.
By yourself?
I'm leaving for 3 weeks. Jess, I can't sit here and watch Schmidt with Fawn. And I don't think they're breaking up anytime soon, so...
Cece, they're never gonna last. He doesn't really love her.
What do you want? I can get you anything you want. You'll be rich, I'll be powerful.
I'm realizing just now that that's not what I want. I don't want any of that. I want to be in love. Come on, Fawn. You're not really in love with me. I'm not really in love with you.
Are you breaking up with me?
I guess I kind of am.
We gotta tell Schmidt that Cece is in love with him. Right now, he is out there throwing away all of his Cece mementos, acting like he's just gonna move on. Jess, I cannot watch this when I know what I know.
I know.
We gotta tell him.
I promised her I wouldn't get involved. I always meddle. I've learned my lesson. She's trying to get Schmidt out of her system. And we have to support her, even if it means letting her climb a mountain with no prior knowledge or experience.
Yeah, but does she know that Schmidt and Fawn broke up? Is she getting our voicemails?
I don't know. She hasn't called me back.
Wally, look, it's a box of memories, but I need that box back, Wally. I need it back more than anything else I've ever needed in my life. Please, I need to move on. We're gonna get Cece back, and I know it's my fault that I lost her.
Sure you know how Cece feels about you?
Yeah, I mean, she said 1,000 times that she only wants to be friends with me. Just Cece doesn't love me, and she never will. So I think it's time to let go.
Nick, Cece's in love with Schmidt.
What? For real?
Can't wait for Cece to get back from her trip. I'm going after her.
Yeah. You go get her.
Okay.
Find that girl.
Hi! Cece!
Cece.
So I was on the top of this mountain and I finally got cell reception and there were like 20 voicemails.
Are you in love with me? Because I'm in love with you.
I'm in love with you.
Really? Mm-hmm. I've known since the minute that I met you. Cecilia Puri.
Oh God, you're gonna say something stupid, aren't you?
Girl, will you marry me?
Yes! Somebody who should be questioning somebody else's judgment, but maybe you should have told your mom you were getting married. I know. I'm just so worried that she's not gonna like Schmidt and then she won't give us her blessing.
Miss Parikh.
Who are you? So you're the man who's marrying my daughter?
Sure am.
No wonder she didn't tell me that she was engaged.
No, no, look, Schmidt. Mom. I'm sorry, I can explain everything.
Miss Parikh, I love Cece. Cece, when were you gonna tell her? On our wedding day, when we were standing beneath our custom hybrid Mandap Hopa?
I'm so sorry, I wanted the moment to be right. I'm sorry. I love him, and he makes me so happy, and I'm gonna marry him.
I will not give my blessing.
Me. You have my blessing.
You have my blessing, too. Mine, too. get a beer and your number?
Actually,
This woman is engaged.
Thank you.
Okay, so you're doing it again.
I'm doing what?
Ever since we got engaged, you've been acting insanely jealous.
You have two choices. You can either spend the rest of your life terrified that somebody's gonna swoop in and steal Cece away, or you can just love her and thank the universe that she loves you back for some reason.
Look, I'm sorry for not being open with you. The truth is I still can't believe that you're gonna marry me. I love you. And I know you love me. I give you my trust. You've always had it. And I don't feel the need to show the world that I own you by putting some gaudy gem on your hand.
I love you.
You know that thing you said before about you not being talented enough? You didn't mean that, right?
Yeah, I did. Newscasters are amazing.
But so are you.
Come on. Schmidt, okay, I'm a bartender and a model. Here.
Cece, I know the audition is scary for you. I would not be doing my job as the man who loves you if I let you walk away from this. Thank God you're here. Look, I'm sorry.
Yeah, we should be. You really pissed me off. Thank you for pushing me. We need to do that kind of thing for each other.
Yes, please.
Is changing. I'm not gonna have this place anymore, and I'm getting married.
Oh my God, Jess, I'm getting married. Are you having second thoughts?
No, I know I want to marry Schmidt more than anything in the world. It's just
everything is gonna change, and I'm scared.
Oh, honey.
Oh,
my little breakfast. You need to call Schmidt.
No, I can't call him and tell him that I'm scared.
I think that's what getting married is. Sharing all this, all the things you're afraid of. You gotta call Schmidt.
About what I said on the phone?
I'm a little freaked out too.
You are?
Yes. And that has nothing to do with how much I love you.
Exactly.
Or how much I want to get married.
Exactly.
We'll be scared together, and we'll be really happy together, too.
Married, Nick. How am I going to defend Cece? She deserves the best husband in the world. What if I don't have what it takes?
Of course you have what it takes to be a modern husband. You're gonna make a great husband to Cece.
How do you know?
Because I know.
Hey, what's wrong?
It's just that you're gonna have two moms at the wedding. I'm not even gonna have one. I really thought that she would just show up last minute because she would know how happy it would make me. Even though there may be time, it seems I'm far away.
Never wonder where I am, as I am always by your side. Cause I'm your lady. Flying to Portland to try to get Cece's mom to come to the wedding. Cece is crushed that her mom is not coming, and I can't take a vow that all I care about is her happiness and not try to do something about it. I know.
Are the most romantic thing that anyone has ever done for me.
I love you so much.
I'm marrying you because you do
this is the happiest
like
day of my life.
It's also so dumb. So dumb.
Just the dumbest.
Mama P, Schmidt with the latest Why I Love Cece. Today's episode, Honesty with a Capital Ouch.
He called you?
Every Monday for the past year.
Just know that if you miss your daughter's wedding, you're gonna regret it for the rest of your life.
I am delighted for you to marry this man.
want to get married?
I don't think that I can wait another second.
Just when I thought you couldn't make me any happier, look what you did today. You're amazing.
I hope for as long as we stay together that I always remain someone that you want to holla at.
I look forward to a lifetime of joy, growth, and constant mispronunciation of common words.
For the first time, I see what the rest of my life looks like.
Look, we'll find a place, okay? I didn't like that house that much anyway.
I just can't be married living with roommate. Look at our wedding photo. I want to hang our wedding photo in our house. I want to start our lives together.
I know.
Honey, we got the house. We got the house! Cece, what the hell are you doing in here?
Surprise!
Cece, I love where your head's at.
Mm-hmm.
I love where your body is at even more, but I can't.
What if I told you that I have the Star of David hidden somewhere on my body and you have to find it?
Okay. Okay, all right, let's do it. We gotta do it really quick. I'm gonna stay dressed and just poke out like a cuckoo clock.
Not here. I got a whole thing planned. Really wanted to do something big for you because you do so many romantic things for me, and I just wanted to find some way to show you how much I love you. Instead, all I did was mess up your job.
You mean more to me than any job ever will. I love Cece.
I love Schmidt. I love him.
Love you.
Love you.
The truth is, it's our boniversary.
Oh.
Kim, this job means so much to me. But she means a lot more. So if this costs me the promotion, then I can live with that.
You know, this is the first conversation we've ever had where you weren't lying to me. It's nice. I'm not flaming with rage. And by the way, I've noticed you working your ass off. Now get back to work. Cece, your décolleté looks beautiful. Thank you.
Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
Hello? Cece, you're pregnant. Cece, you're pregnant.
Oh my God, Cece's pregnant.
Who the hell is this?
Sorry, I'm Allie, Winston's fiance.
Cece is pregnant? What, Winston? I'm using social media. Oh my God, Schmidt, why didn't you tell me you're gonna be a papa?
No.
What do you mean, papa? What are you talking about?
Pull the plug.
Sadie told Allie that Cece is pregnant.
Pull the plug.
Why would she do that?
Because she's pregnant.
Winston, he doesn't know.
Know that.
Is that true? What's going on?
Hey, Schmidt, it's Jess. I'm so sorry. I picked up Cece's phone. It was Sadie, and she told me the news, and now everybody knows but Cece. So I'm gonna send her home.
Okay, but Jess, please. Is it true?
Yeah, it's true.
Just get home.
She needs to hear it from you.
Hey, babe, I'm back.
Woo. What's happening?
I'm pregnant.
What?
I mean, you're pregnant. We're pregnant. Sadie called you. And Jess picked up. And then she called again, and Winston picked up. Winston told me. upsetting scene. We're having a baby, Cece.
We're having a baby.
We're having a
baby. My name is Ruth Bader Parikh Schmidt, and I am 3 today. Can you say that? Close enough. Okay, but where is Daddy's butt? I gotta get to the office.
Daddy's butt has been bleaching all outdoor playing surfaces. You could prepare a chicken on that slide.
Hmm, great. Well, I gotta go help one of my models.
Oh, don't forget the cooler.
I won't forget the cooler.
Happy birthday, dear Ruth. Happy birthday to you.
Let me ask you a question.
Uh-huh.
We're at my funeral. Mm. Ka-thunk goes my coffin. Shovel dirt, shovel dirt, shovel dirt. You wipe the schmutz off your pretty black dress and stopwatch is ticking. How long do you wait to remarry?
I don't know, 3 years.
3 years? 3 years? Not even a full presidential? Your new husband would still be finding my bobby pins and couch cushions.
I only blurted out 3 years because I don't even want to think about you being gone. I don't know what I would do without you. I would end up dragging a lawn chair out to your grave on the 4th of July and lighting a sparkler, and Ruth wouldn't want to come with me because she would say, Mommy, Kevin's having a party and I don't want to go to the grave again. Okay, so I'm just alone on a chair and I miss you.
I don't want you alone at my grave. I want you to find someone who's going to take care of you, who's going to love you as much as I do.
I just want you.
So I'm going to die and I need you to take care of my wife.
Super.
We're fine. Thank you.
Okay. Stressed out. I know that I said that I would go back to work when Ruth started school, which, look, I'm excited about, but I've been out of the game for a while, and I've become accustomed to a different type of lifestyle.
We'll be fine. What you see as a life or death mission, I see as a week off with my daughter.
Wrong again. Buckle up. Sorry I went overboard with the binders before.
No, I'm sorry. I honestly don't know how you do this every single day. How's work?
Friggin' crushed it.
Oh, great.
And I think I want to quit.
What, really?
I just kept wishing that I was here taking care of Ruth. It's the best job I've ever had. What would you think if I was home full time?
I think that anything that makes you happy and keeps those binders away from me, that's what you should do.
Hear your voice. Hear your voice. If you're gone, I'm here. I'll come meet you. Meet.